Like most photographers, I'm always looking for ways to improve my image quality. In the past, I've often done this by upgrading my cameras and lenses, as I'm sure many of you have. But what about some of those great images that you've already shot? A new camera or lens isn't going to help you improve those. And a new camera and lens is also quite expensive, so is there an alternative? Well, I think there is, and we can do it using software. One package that offers this is Topaz Photo AI, and in this video I'll look at the results I've been able to achieve. I'll start by demonstrating the software using a RAW file because there's a surprising result that I want to share later. This image was shot using an Olympus EM5 Mark III, which is a Micro Four Thirds camera. Let's open the RAW file in Topaz Photo AI. Immediately the software begins to analyse the file and applies any corrections that it thinks are required. Now I've paused the screen to show you this because the process was complete before I could explain it. But I also want to share a word of warning. I used to find this software too slow on my old Intel Mac, which is why I didn't bother with it. Now that I'm using a new Mac Studio and the latest version of Topaz Photo AI, it seems vastly quicker. But what I don't know is how it will perform on older equipment. Before buying this software, you do need to test it on your own computer. Now let's look at what the software does. The first thing seems to be that it applies a lens correction to the RAW file. Watch what happens to the trees when I move the split screen left and right. You can see them move because I'm assuming the adjusted image on the right has a lens correction applied to it. I'll also point out that the image here is magnified to 100%, which you can control at the bottom right of the interface. The options for adjusting the image are also over on the right side of the interface. Currently, Photo AI is applying a noise reduction. When I click the heading, it expands to show more options. Here we have two AI models to process the RAW file with. If I hover my mouse over the heading, we can see what each is best for. Now this image was taken at the camera's base ISO, which doesn't have much noise. Based on this, the AI has selected the best AI model to use. We can also see the level of noise reduction, and it's applying a small amount of deblur to the RAW file. I can see this effect on my monitor, but I don't know if it will be visible in the video. Now let's increase the size of the image using the upscale feature. When I turn that on, the image is doubled in size. As with the denoise option, we can click the upscale heading to expand it. Now we can see the option to increase the image size by 2, 4 or max, which is 6 times. There's also the option to enter your own dimensions, but I'll stick with doubling it. As you can see, that will produce an image that's over 10,000 pixels by 7,000 pixels, which is big enough for most people's use. Below this, we have a choice of AI models to use for the upscaling. If I move my mouse over the heading again, we can see the description to help us. The software has automatically selected the high fidelity option for this RAW file. Then below this, we have some controls which we can use to fine-tune the denoising, deblurring, and fix any compression artifacts. The software has again selected these, so I'll leave them as they are. We can also see that the remove noise option that we were looking at earlier has been disabled because the noise reduction is now handled in the upscaling. At first glance, the detail the software is pulling from the RAW file appears very impressive, so let's look at the option for sharpening. When I turn that on, additional sharpening is now applied to the subject. Let's expand the sharpening section to see the other options. If I move my mouse over the subject heading, you can see the red mask indicating the subject area selected by the software. And I also have the option to turn off the subject sharpening. But I won't do that because it will sharpen everything in this scene, including the sky. Instead, I'm going to choose to edit the subject. I can then select the option telling the software that this is a landscape so it can refine the selection. Notice this changes the red mask selecting the ground but not the sky. If there are any areas that aren't correctly selected, I can then use the brush tools to refine the selection. I'll use the AI brush to subtract the clouds from the top right of the frame. After that, I can click the apply button to apply the update. Now I can go back to the sharpening section and change the sharpening settings if I need to. Again, there are different AI models to apply sharpening. Standard is pretty good for this image, but standard version 2 appears better and it will soon replace the standard model. I'm happy with how the image looks now, so I'll choose the save option to open the queue window. Here I can select from different settings, including the format for saving the image. Because I started with an unprocessed RAW file, I'll output this to a DNG image saved to the original folder. Now let's look at the results magnified at 100%. Although the image still needs adjusting, it seems to be packed with detail. But here's where things get surprising. Let's look at the detail at a higher magnification. When I do that, it seems there is a fine grain in the image, which can become exaggerated if I adjust the image. I don't think this is a problem, as it isn't visible when the image is printed, and it does seem to enhance the image sharpness. But it is something to be aware of, because some people may find this a problem. After noticing this, I decided to test a JPEG image rather than the RAW file and then compare the two. Here are some sections of the image, magnified to 100%. The image on the left is the JPEG and the image on the right is the DNG file. Surprisingly, across the frame, the JPEG produced better results. I also found that starting with a higher quality JPEG improved the results even further. But there was one further test that I was wondering about, which is how the Photo AI image compares with the Topaz gigapixel image enlargement. Well, here's the result of running the JPEG through both applications to double the image size. Take a moment to look at the two and decide which you think is best. I don't know if you'll be able to see this clearly in the video, but on my monitor, it's the image on the left. That's the one produced by gigapixel using its default settings. And it was the same across the frame. Following this conclusion, I wondered if Topaz Gigapixel was any better at resizing than Photoshop. Fortunately, I'd already made this video to answer that question. Thanks for watching today, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and please share this. I'll see you soon for another video.